Hey, what's up? It's Richard, RMAutodiag here, and today we are going to have a look at 5-volt vehicle reference circuits and temperature sensors. Alright everyone, we're going to get straight into this. We've just got a little Peugeot 1007 as a bit of a test car. There's no actual fault with this car, but we can see what it is and see what we can do with it. Some basic tests. As I say, I'll put a link in the description below for my website where I've done a bit of a write-up on 5-volt reference circuits. So let's have a go. Alright, I have disconnected it, so we'll have a look at a code that had come up. We've got a P0118, engine coolant temperature, short to positive or open circuit. So that's a pretty standard code if you've got an issue there. We can have a look at live data, and we go into cooling. See what we've got. You can see we've got 12 degrees C, and car is not running, hasn't been ran. See if I can just put you down here a minute. We've got temperature sensor in view here. A few little things you can do is we'll be verifying, is it the right temperature? We've got some cheap infrared probes. We've got about 10 degrees on that. Or you can go a bit more upmarket. Not absolutely necessary, but same result on a thermal imager. And if you don't have either of those, usually with a multimeter, you'll get a little temperature probe that you can plug in and pick up temperature as well there. But just a good little test just to verify if the sensor's reading coherent there. And I think we're pretty close. 10 degrees, said, I think it said 12 degrees on live data, so we're pretty happy with that. Okay, so next we'll get down to doing some meter checks. Okay, first checks I would do is disconnect the sensor. Let's get that under there. And we can see if we have any sort of 5-volt feed. Just got the other end of the test leads connected to the battery negative. And zero on that. And we've got 5-volt feed there, as you can see. If we jump across to this one and we move our other negative meter lead across, we've got about 12 volts, so we can be happy that that's a reasonable earth. And if you want to check it both in place, both in there, we should see 5, which we do. So I'd be fairly happy that circuit's intact at the moment. So from here, the next thing I would do would probably be a bypass test if we were suspecting that the sensor had gone open circuit. So we'll just go find a resistance box. Okay, I'm pretty sure you guys have probably seen one of these on eBay. Pretty cheap to get hold of. There are nicer ones out there. And all you've got to do is put this in line. And we can change up the resistance here. Let's get it in shot. So we can turn it at 1000 ohms to 3000 ohms. And what we're looking for there is a change on our scan tool. So let's see if I can get that in shot. So put that under a graphing mode there. So if I turn the dial, change the resistance on the deco box, we should see a change in temperature. So that's at 4,000 ohms, 5,000 ohms, and you drop it back down to 2,000 ohms. And you can see the changes in temperature. That's a good response from the ECU with this decade box in the way. So, you know, we can be fairly happy that all the wiring's intact, the ECU responds, and you know, I would be putting a temperature sensor in there if that was the suspected fault. So that's a pretty good test. I mean, that's my preferred method most of the time, as long as it's accessible. Also, just a quick note here, just to be looking at it, we've got a reading of minus 43 there. Usually you'll see some sort of ridiculous reading when things are open circuit or short circuit. They'll either be, you know, maxed completely out or completely negative, one of the two. So we've got it disconnected at the moment, reading minus 43. When we plug it back in, it should go back to a normal temperature. So there we go, back up to our 12 degrees. Again, another reasonable test for verifying things. The only other test you could do would be with the plug disconnected. You could get your multimeter in there and do a continuity test across the two pins in the sensor. That's a bit awkward trying to get in some places, so it's not really my preferred test method. As I say, the bypass test with the decade resistance box is the preferred, because it proves so many things at once. And yeah, that's the basics of it. As I say, guys, there's a bit of a write-up on how it all exactly works on my website, so yeah, check that out if you want to go any further. Hopefully that quick little demo was some use to you guys. So yeah, if you could smash the like button, comment in the comment section below if you've got any questions or you want to put anything else to this, and click the subscribe button. All right, thanks for watching.